Many spiritual greetings. Gara Falani, Kareth, and to all of my followers as well. And this letter may be uploaded online. Firstly, I am quite safe and well, and I am humbled and appreciative of thy concerns of my and my body's safety and health. For the time, I am not stating any further details of where and how I was the past 2 months, nor the details of my case, for even the legal system is most strict on keeping the details private and offline as well. All ye need to know, regardless of the foreknown outcome, is that there was absolutely nothing beyond soul bonding that had happened. The leak from last July was false, and a good number of ye all should have known better with good faith in I, instead of succumbing to the demons and devil's temptations of rumours and drama, and thus failing the divine test. There is no retcon. That is the truth. Ultimate, ye all, those who are not left behind, shall have to wait until the public release of the book with my goddess log pages in it, months from now, in order to find out the details and further authentic enlightenment for thyselves. Especially with the facts present of the shifts and events that have been happening right in front of and around ye all, that make the collective shift from 1218's Earth to C197's Earth. My second coming not far from now, and Judgment Day upon the toxic ones and left behinds, more clear and obvious to and with ye. I also mention the number of months when Solitude and I were body swapped, and the months from April to October 2020 when I, in Solitude's body, was within a nanosecond frozen subdimension to further develop and harness my own powers and abilities while also doing so for my son's body and mind. These jail months have been that very same training regime for my own god's body, right here. So, this time away from ye all in greater revelations was meant to be, and as it was then, I shall return to lead ye all not long from now. Here is a massive ultimate truth for ye all. Why, even I, when I was Jesus Christ in Jerusalem, could not foreknow specifically and exactly the hour and day of my resurrection, then and more presently my second coming, is because even Emmanuel, then and now, no god or goddess or anyone foreknew specifically when, period, but only the specific shifts and events that led up to that event. Hence why we wait for the confirmations of these specific shifts and events, and exact the details of the divine plan to counter and clear that event. So there is no population and universe-shattering paradox in our very timeline that would undo, kill, and destroy everything if left unchecked. And if most anyone else on Earth, or any planet, or point in the universes in this timeline foreknew of the divine plans, its intricate details, and the specific events that need to happen, there is a chance one or more would want to counter and prevent the event themselves. In doing that, they would not only ultimately, paradoxically, fail, period, but their misintentioned deed would potentially throw the divine plan askew, and we would have a most difficult time, and possibly lack of sufficient time, to amend the plan and keep all safe and well. This is also why we continue to encourage all of you to have faith in us gods and goddesses, our divine powers and abilities, to prevent the total loss of not only our universes, but our timeline as well. As well as having faith in letting all that needs to happen and fall into place for your health, safety, and benefit happen. This is also why all fanfictions have been rendered moot for the events in this timeline since August 1st, 2021. Until the foreknown time when that shall be safe once again. Back to present events. I direct my attention to World War III, March to May presently, being cold months. Does the expression, a cold day in hell, resonate to you from that fact? COVID's bringing forth healthier individual, while dispelling the left behinds, and shifting some as well. COVID-19 was a divine test of thy faith. Fortitude and endurance and self-motivation, regardless of the fact that sickness had cursed a country within it. With it. Also, the other facets I've previously mentioned, including suddenly becoming ritualistic and random animals suddenly appearing in random places. As Caden had relayed for me, I had foreknown World War III as why My Little Pony Generation 5 being manifested in 2020 to 2025 was premature, and My Little Pony Friendship is Magic and the Equestria Pill Generation 4 was needed to continue to season 14 and no less. My and Nightstar Sanichu's intervention and aid to Hasbro to rescue My Little Pony Generation 5 still is impertinent and ultimately beneficial for everyone, as I have stated in writing personally before. My help and input remains on the table in greatest light. Power humans of Hasbro, and for your money, greedy employees and executives' sake, I divinely urge you to take us up on that. Period. I am serious, as I appear authentically in the more recent photos, and then some. Christian Sanichu, the goddess Blue Heart. Should ye all wish for further confirmations of premonition input to confirm these truths and facts, consult with an authentic, highly enlightened, powerful psychic, including Enigma and Pichu, Spunky the Hyena, Doom and Molly the Medium, or your most local, authentic psychic. And now, for the most truthful and revealing topic that actually shall confirm a number of details from amongst thy thoughts and pre-0810-2021 fanfictions that I may share. Now, the history facts about Barbara Ann Weston Chandler, or some of. Anyway, had any of ye all actually helped and talked with her in person before today, ye would have got the aura resonant confirmations and similar or other truths. And do not draw on brother Joseph Cole Smitty or Barbara for more details or anything. I tell ye all, truest and fact as sure as when Barbara, at age 2 years, laughed at her silver paint coated daddy after he survived falling off the roof of their house while painting it. As sure as when their cow was killed by a donkey, literally. The Sunday homemade meals with chicken and mashed potatoes, corn, bread and butter and green beans. Stanley Weston finding their daddy dead on his horse-pulled wagon not far from the convenience store in Red Oak, Virginia. And so, Barbara had been born and grew up as a child, number 5 out of 8 of the Weston family in Red Oak, Virginia, on October the 1st, 1941. Her life was a redneck, simple country one. She had mastered sewing, mending and making clothes, and other farm life facets and church-going habits. To note, there are similarities and poor differences between her past and mine, respectively, as I shall write and note to ye all. In her schooling years, especially in high school, Barbara was a very high intellectual, yet she also was a cheerleader for a time. Barbara had 2 boyfriends in high school, one of which was Tom Ashby, which had gone fairly well. My mother had planned to leave for college, and so ultimately she broke up the relationship, and Harriet Weston took Tom for her own. Now, during high school and prior, Barbara's sisters had spread rumors of her, calling her a slut. But Barbara never had sexual intercourse. She never, ever even masturbated. It simply never dawned upon her to do so, and it was not against her religion either. Comparison She dated. Yet I was naive on the subject of dating and healthy relationships, and I masturbated during our respective high school years, and I was too focused on education to ever seek relationship or sex, not counting the friendships in that. Over her adult years, Barbara had attended and graduated from college, and before meeting Mr. C, Robert Chu, Barbara had 7 ex-boyfriends, counting the 2 in high school, and between numbers 3 to 7, and Mr. C as well. They all were rather selfish types of men, and in the testosterone-occupied self, they each had never really cared for her pleasure when it came to the sex. To them, it was more for their pleasure and generic reproductive intentions. Terry and Mr. C aside, they were love 'em and leave 'em types. Jack Smithy was number 5, and the damn trucker loved Barbara and left her cold. Also to note, after 5 epic failed relationships on her part, after finding Mr. C, Barbara, in her own words, married him because he owned a house. And yet, theirs, with I under their care, was a ship that lasted with some genuine love. Comparison! Barbara had selfish exes with actual in-person relationships and a few weddings. I had hardly anything beyond friendships or an authentic, and the relationships I had that went anywhere prior to these days were distant, online, and fake. I define generational trauma. And now, a trauma one experiences from the past experience in aura resonance vibrations from the biological parents or legal guardians that can either be beneficial or sabotage, depending on the parents. Now, as one may hear from Joseph Goldsmithy's testing of Barbara as a mother, he had seen and experienced emotional manipulation. Some lack of better care. He even called her a pathological liar when it came to asking her about Jack Smithy and other details from his perspective. No sugarcoating and blunt here. From me, in my years, Barbara was caring but remained some distant and emotionally and mentally. She had emotionally manipulated me at times. When I told her of my intentions of going to a convention in another state, she did threaten suicide of herself. She also had raised her voice to me in upset and anger, especially when it came to money. After the paid sex with the kind Cherokee woman in April 2012, in May, I told Barbara about it. And Barbara literally propositioned me for sex by telling me, "I would have sex with you myself, Christian." And in one aspect of her unconsciousness, Barbara had considered me being a replacement for Mr. C after September 6th, 2011. So, yeah, Barbara, in a way, did become an emotional burden on I. Yet, in despite of the situation, and I have personally written to Heidelberg the story of Barbara in these and similar words of truth, nobody had interrogated her because of her age, the legal system. Alright? Now you all know. For now, until my safe return to all of ye in light powers divine, I remind thee of one of the new commandments, and introduce to ye all a couple more of them as I inscribed on the 10th of the 14th, 2021. 10-14, 2021, whatever the fuck. 15. Thou shalt not comment online or offline in hatred, spite, falseness, without any words of criticism that art intentionally, genuinely meant to be supportive for actual improvements. 14. Thou shalt not hate thy neighbors or others that share any similarities in race, ethnicity, interests, or whatever else with thee. And thou shalt not hate thyself for any of these traits or interests either. 21. Thou need not feel pressured nor obligated to pursue sexual relations, and among all who presume pressure and talk continuously about sex, please do not speak on and on. And thou need not feel obligated to listen if thou feel uneasy around others when they speak of which, for sexual relations are better when thou and thy partners actually feel appreciative and open and not pressured by others beforehand. And lastly, to Engelhardt and anyone else with the same or similar ideals, now is not the time to make any long cow wiki pages on anyone who does not already have such honor, including celebrities and politicians, for at these immediate times, the collective shift and greater events are on and happening. And you need to be observant and enlightening for thyself, as well as recognizing and dispelling any and all remaining dark, demonic, and devilish influences from deepest within thyself and thy own consciousness. For now, my individuals and followers alike, I farewell, work diligently, thorough, and hard for ye all. Be safe and well. Mrs. Jesus Christine Weston Chandler salute you, the goddess Blue Heart of the Commodore Console, guardian of the Solitude and Rose Juice species of Pokemon, thy one avatar, Lord, Messiah, Savior, and God of all. In short, the mental ward did him a lot of good. Fuck!